Everything starts off low at the bottom. You see the color of the nitrates in the nitrites? It's at the bottom. Sansuchi. 1, 2. Shake once. All right, we're gonna lay here. We're gonna see what's going on in the water. So fortunately for us, there's test day two. So here's test day two. It's pretty much the same results. Okay, the water hardness, again, the same as last time, it's the maximum. It says 800 plus. Chlorine in the water, again, there's nothing, zero. Alkalinity, 120. pH, so again, this is the water test from Sansuchi after the algae bloom, and you can clearly see here that the nitrates and nitrites are basically at zero.
I am El Nino. All other tropical storms must bow before El Nino. Yo soy El Nino. For those of you who don't habla Espanol, El Nino is Spanish for the Nino.
Who would have thought that 2020 would be like this? It's just insane. So just hug your family, tell people you love them, and stay safe.
Hundreds of fires burn across the West tonight. There is great concern that between the extreme heat and the pandemic,
California this morning, the Bay Area is partly surrounded by a series of major wildfires.
This morning, a South Florida town is breathing a sigh of relief after a scary tornado touchdown. A water spout forms out in the water only to land near Golden Beach.
You were on the call, we come here.
Tornado time, baby. Right out our window.
A viewer stayed relatively calm while watching this outside his window. Cell phone video shows a waterspout off the coast of Golden Beach near Aventura.
It pretty much looked like the sky was all black and it was dark.
Chopper 4 was overhead after to see some of the minor damage left behind, like outside furniture being tossed into the ocean. The town of Golden Beach sent us pictures of downed trees.
This new, I'm going to call it an algae bloom, sounds like a seaweed bloom more than anything else. Is this new? You've not seen it before?
Yeah, so it's been happening since around 2010. And I don't know whether it's just a cycle that we're in a period of time where it's more intense than usual or whether it's a trend. No one can tell that. But it's happening right now, and it's a real problem for tourism in a lot of the small tourist islands.
What was this about dust from the Sahara Desert blowing over? I mean, is that a red herring, to coin a phrase?
It's not a red herring, no. So that's an interesting one, too. A little bit complicated. I'll tell you a real simple story about it. So there's a red tide along the Gulf Coast, and after a while, red tides run out of nitrogen. They need nitrogen as one of the nutrients to grow. The Saharan dust is pretty heavy this year, and it's bringing over iron, and the iron is fueling the growth of a different kind of algae that's able to take nitrogen out of the atmosphere and give it to the red tide. It's keeping that tide going longer than we've ever seen before in the recent past.
This is fascinating, but it's terrible news for the tourist industry because you don't have a short-term fix for either the first, the second, or the third algae bloom, do you?
No, I mean, so I go to the beach every year, and this is the first year I've experienced it, and chances are next year everything will be fine again. You know, it's one of those things where it's just a perfect storm this year, and we're having these problems.
Well, thanks for reporting it, Carl. We do appreciate that, even if we don't like the news. Carl Havens, everyone, algae specialist. We'll see you again soon. Thanks, Carl.
Okay.
It's dense and dirty. A gigantic dust cloud nicknamed Godzilla.
Seen from space, traveling thousands of miles from North Africa and through the Caribbean. Here's Puerto Rico before and after, now sweeping parts of the southeast.
This particular event has characteristics that have not been seen, at least in the past 25 to 30 years. The sheer area covered by the dust in the atmosphere.
Technically, it's called the Saharan Air Layer, a large plume of very fine dust and sand particles formed over the Sahara Desert, typically seen during late spring, summer, and early fall.
Is there anything that people should be doing when going outside?
Persons who are susceptible to respiratory problems, asthma, so on, would want to avoid being outside.
Research suggests air pollution could make COVID cases worse. All the more reason to wear a mask, which scientists say will also help with the dust. It's the latest in a summer of extremes, including a record-setting heat wave in Siberia. There's even been a swarm of locusts, billions of them, wreaking havoc in parts of East Africa and South Asia. The biggest outbreak some countries have seen in 70 years. Thankfully, Godzilla is forecast to eventually make its way out over the Atlantic. In the meantime, some are enjoying spectacular sunsets, like this stunner out of Texas.
I'll suffer the sinuses just a little bit to get a really pretty picture and everything that's going on in this world. And we're just really blessed to be able to see that every single night.
Proof every cloud has a silver lining. But in this case, it's gold. For today, Erin McLaughlin, NBC News.
When you eat a tomato from Florida, chances are it was grown in African soil. But not because someone shipped the dirt over there or anything. Every year, tons of dust from the Sahara Desert is kicked up by dust storms, blasted high into the sky, and whisked across the Atlantic Ocean on wind currents. It takes about a week, and then it's hello, Florida. In fact, our oceans and continents are all linked into this weird global dust ecosystem. Scientists estimate that more than 30% of the soil in Barbados comes from Africa. And the stuff in the Bahamas and the Florida Keys? Mostly African imports. Besides being weird to think about, the dust is also really important. In fact, without African dust, the vegetation on some Caribbean islands wouldn't be nearly so lush. See, those islands, along with parts of Florida, are mostly built of crusty coral. When that coral breaks down, it leaves a pile of broken-up calcium, which on its own isn't that fertile. But blast over some African dust, and voila! You've suddenly got nutrients in your soil, like magnesium, phosphorus, and potassium, and things get a whole lot greener. Dust nourishes soil all over the world, too, including in the Amazon rainforest and northern Hawaiian islands. So on your next tropical vacation, you can thank dust for the scenery.
A 20-million-ton algae bloom is lingering off the coast of Florida.
It's actually one of the biggest experts have ever seen. The massive mat stretches all the way from West Africa to the Caribbean. Right now, it's pushing heaps of seaweed onto beaches along Florida's east coast. NBC2's Devin Turk talked to experts to find out if we could start seeing the same thing along our coastline. He's live on the Sanibel Causeway tonight.
Well, Sean, the water right now in the Sanibel Causeway looks fantastic. This is nothing like what we saw last year right around this time. But scientists do warn millions of tons of that algae are out there in the Gulf. And if the wind changes, we could see it on our beaches.
While Southwest Florida beaches are looking clear.
That looks beautiful. Great day. A lot of people out in the water.
Thousands of pounds of a brown algae called sargassum seaweed is taking over and stinking up beaches on Florida's east coast and the Keys.
It doesn't help the tourist dollars that come down here for summer, that's for sure.
University of South Florida scientists are monitoring what they call one of the biggest algae blooms ever, 20 million tons from West Africa to the Gulf of Mexico. FGCU's Dr. James Douglas says he's worried about what this means for our nearshore ecosystem.
When there are big rotting clumps of it, it releases its nutrients into the water, and those nutrients can cause other harmful algae blooms, can hurt seagrasses and coral reefs, and that's also bad for the tourism.
Dr. Douglas says the seaweed has always been found in tropical waters, but there's been more in recent years than ever before.
Because there's so much nutrients now entering the ocean through the atmosphere and river discharges like the Mississippi and the Amazon, that now nutrient pollution is reaching the open ocean where the sargassum grows.
It typically avoids our area because of prevailing winds, but as an avid windsurfer, he says he's seen it out in the Gulf.
Well, I know it's out here, not so far off our coasts. All it would take would be a change in the winds to have this start washing up on our coast.
And Dr. Douglas does say clumps of it can be used for compost. He said we need to reduce the global nutrient problem that fuels this. Reporting live in the Sanibel Causeway, Devin Turk, NBC2.
The Saharan dust is pretty heavy this year, and it's bringing over iron. And the iron is fueling the growth of a different kind of algae that's able to take nitrogen out of the atmosphere and give it to the red tide.